This is not your ordinary run-of-the-mill recession. We are going through the worst economic crisis since the Great Depression.
このように 私どもを取り巻く環境は極めて厳しく、当期は営業損失とならざるを得ないというかつてない緊急事態に直面いたしております。
The poorest and most vulnerable groups risk the most serious and in some cases permanent damage.
The government has tried to do what I call more or less a kitchen sink approach. In other words, throwing everything in, bailing out banks, bailing out insurance companies, bailing out automobile companies, providing relief for mortgages, whatever it might take, the government's tried to do. And it's doing that at great cost.
The crisis clearly will have a long-standing impact on the credibility of America's financial model, the credibility of a model that hinged on sort of fairly light regulation of the financial sector, that argued that markets were self-regulating so that the government could sort of have its hands off and not worry too much if large financial intermediaries were taking very big bets.
To understand the origins of this financial crisis, you have to go back to the mid-2000s when an enormous amount of money was flowing into the world economy, notably from China and from other export surplus countries. This fueled a big credit bubble. The Federal Reserve failed to raise interest rates to constrain this bubble, and so people could borrow money for all kinds of things, most notably real estate. When this real estate bubble finally burst in 2007, it created the opposite effect with a kind of cascade of other sorts of debt that were no longer available. And this fed through finally in 2008, first of all, to the collapse of Bear Stearns, the investment bank, to the collapse in 1 week of Lehman Brothers and AIG, the insurance company, and then a sort of generalized freeze up in the payment system where nobody trusted anybody else, which meant there was no cash for businesses. That's when the real economy tanked.
Употребление допингом дешевых денег и проблемы с ипотекой в Соединенных Штатах Америки породили настоящую цепную реакцию, вызвали паралич мировой финансовой системы и всеобщее недоверие на рынках, что, конечно же, не могло не сказаться на реальных секторах экономики. И кризис, начавшийся как финансовый, на наших глазах превратился в кризис экономический.
Is globalization under threat? The answer is yes. There will be countries that will be seduced by putting on trade controls in order to redress some of these burdens that they face because of this globalized recession. Politicians in many countries are grumpy.
L'Europe doit poser une réponse unie et une réponse qui ne doit pas être naïve face à la concurrence des grandes autres régions du monde. Notre devoir, c'est qu'en Europe, on puisse continuer à construire des avions, des bateaux, des trains, des automobiles, parce que l'Europe a besoin d'une industrie puissante.
또 아니면 금융 위기로 인해서 각국이 보호무역주의로 후퇴해서는 안 된다는 것을 역설했습니다. 보호무역주의는 또 다른 보호무역주의를 이야기해서 세계 경제를 더욱 침체시키고 그 피해는 경제 구조가 취약한 신흥 경제구에 더욱 클 것이기 때문입니다.
I think the current crisis is a significant threat to the future of capitalism because people are naturally going to interpret the crisis as a failure of markets rather than a failure of policy. I think that's unfortunate because there were so many government policies that served to fuel the crisis. Monetary policy, the role of government-sponsored enterprises like Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, the role of government-authorized institutions like credit ratings agencies, tax policy that encouraged both households and financial institutions to build up debt. all of these things played a very significant role. It wasn't just greedy bankers.
Ich sage ganz eindeutig, wir brauchen Finanzmärkte in einer modernen globalen Wirtschaft. Aber wir brauchen nicht ungezähmte Finanzmärkte, in denen der Profit das Einzige ist, was zählt und die Gier, sondern wir brauchen Finanzmärkte mit Regeln, die in die soziale Marktwirtschaft hineinpassen. Darum geht es und das müssen wir schaffen.
Nosotros no creemos en eso de que el Estado tiene que limitarse, pasar a retaguardia y que viva el libre mercado. Laissez-faire, laissez-passer. Esa es la causa de la tragedia que está viviendo el pueblo de Estados Unidos y que amenaza a medio mundo.
We need to rebuild these international institutions, to have an early warning system so that we are better prepared for what happens, to have greater cooperation across borders between supervisors and regulators, to have a better crisis prevention mechanism so that when things happen, the international community can come together more effectively. And that has been missing for some of the period in which we've been dealing with this financial crisis. To have a better surveillance of the world economy and therefore a better guide for countries in difficulty to take action for the future.
Fifty years from now, I think this crisis will be viewed as an inflection point in the gradual decline of US power, at least in a relative sense. These forces of relative decline are driven by things really other than the financial crisis. They're driven by the rise of the Asian economies, population shifts, the sheer logic of demography, and the fact that a technological lead in the United States can't be sustained forever.